So I'm guessing I don't have as much planned for today, or I'm realizing I don't have as much planned for today as I thought. We'll jump right in another one of these. So we're back to, Run's giving us like atrocious rate of fire. Rate of fire is, it doesn't take much to put it in the realm of like normalcy. The more you have, the more you, or the higher your rate of fire, or the higher your number, the more you gain from each change. So all it really is gonna take is, I think one of those will drop us down to like 13 rate of fire, which is still not great. But it's pretty good. Lusty Blood, of course, amazing. The Yeru we got, fucking great. I'm mostly worried about our absolutely trash rate of fire combining with our absolutely trash item and starting health. If we get one singular spirit heart, I think we'll be alright. And I'm probably gonna go in this shop to see if I can't use Yara spirit heart. I can, and then try something else. Drop a nickel. Thank you. There we go. Are you a wizard with this rate of fire? Is probably the worst thing we could possibly have had happen to us, but I guess we didn't just get direct damage or anything like that. God, Ogre Tears are the best. Oh, this is gonna be a rough room. Once we get a couple of them, we'll be able to just coast off of the increased damage, but this rate of fire is really gonna hurt us. I don't know what our, let's see, I think we'll see by the end of this room what our maximum damage bonus will be. Our maximum damage number, 10.01. Looks like that's the highest it's gonna get. And that's pretty fucking high. I'm not gonna use, I had a moment where I thought maybe I should use, what's it called? Kamikaze, and blow up that thing, but I don't think that's worth it. If it doesn't have a spirit heart in it, all that happens is we lost some damage. Oh, it got destroyed by the hole in the wall, hole in the ground. Let's go buy that spirit heart and then move on. I want an active item to just take Kamikaze off of our hands. Because I keep treating it like it's a last ditch bomb, and it's not until I have some sort of, if I get Pyromaniac, this will be the best imaginable situation. But until I get Pyromaniac, it's pretty stupid to even think about it. We need keys badly. We'll get into the shop for free. Or maybe we can buy a key. On the cheap, yeah, okay. How is our rate of fire so much better? Oh my god. We got, I didn't even notice that. We got a Binky. And that just now we have nothing to worry about with this run, basically. That's all it took. It put us to freaking 9 from 18. That's insane. That's like, that's a ridiculous amount of improvement. That's like too much from one place. There we go. Now I don't have that freaking thing looming over our heads. Alright, this went from dog shit to dynamite. So, we're pretty good to just move along. I mean, things I want now. Base increase of damage for bosses that don't spawn. Or rooms that don't have a ton of enemies. Other than that, nothing to worry about. Nothing to even consider. A rate of fire is good enough to last us for 3 or more floors at this point. I've already killed one of these. So. All you gotta do for Gemini here is get a couple boogers on him and remember the creep. Alright, well, shit, dude. That's another damage increase every 6 rooms, and the thing we really want from Book of Sin is the Spirit Hearts. They're now guaranteed, so. Also, we can just destroy rocks for free. Everything's great. And our rate of fire, or our speed, is high enough to, we don't even really need to worry about when we use them. I mean, so 3 more billboards out of Ebbing, Missouri. Probably one of my favorite movies of last year. It's one of those movies where you kind of love and kind of hate everyone. And I think that that's... Damn, I couldn't do anything about that. I mean, that's of course what they're going for with the movie. People are complex, the relationships are based on so many different things that... no one's all bad or all good. That's pretty much the central organizing principle. Even the most loathsome characters get a redemption arc to some degree. I think except for the dad, he's kind of a piece of shit. But otherwise, and I love Frances McDormand. She's a big reason why Fargo is one of my favorite movies. And she's incredibly well utilized in 3 Billboards. I don't know if 3 Billboards is a Coen Brothers movie, but it doesn't feel like it. It doesn't have the same kind of irreverence that Coen Brothers movies have. Even No Country for Old Men has this feeling of like something on the back burner. Like, it's not lighthearted, but it's kind of like a wink when you think about it. Pick this up. Use it once. Get the bookworm effect. Come on, something good. Something good. That's something good. And start working right now at BFF. Doesn't really help with this guy, but helps in general. Oh. I was unsure as to whom had the booger. On whom the booger lied. Lay. On whom the booger lay. That's how you say that statement. I really want to always say everything as properly as possible, but I sometimes honestly just don't know what the right way to say something. Lay is past tense for lie. Yuck. This room is too volatile. Why is what you do when you're sleepy? The ley line thing is something I fuck up way more often than I would like to be true. It is weird that shopkeepers counters kills, but not that weird. Give me a spirit heart. If it turns out to be possible, I'll get Box a friend because I have BFF, but I'm not super worried about it. Alright, not wasting bombs in here. Stupid shit. Gotta be kidding me, you stupid shit. Dude, I do this room so slowly. Because I'm so bad at pushing these things. Yeah, there we go. Not at all. Not today, Bobby. Bobby B. Alright, we need one of these that has multiple things spit out. Damn. Both at the same time? Got it. I know it's weird because I was at 18 rate of fire recently, but like I feel like it's time for another increase in the old ROF. Things have slowed down a little bit too greatly. Or not slowed down, but stayed too similar for situation. Man, I probably didn't need Dark Bomb. Now I'm thinking about it. Every six rooms we're making freaking... What? How did that one ricochet backwards like that? Okay, maybe I absolutely need Dark Bomb because I can't dodge Peeper Eyes. Like, even a little bit. What the fuck? Okay, yeah. This was a mistake. Go get it. Go get it. I know you see it. Why does it feel like my movement speed is down even when I haven't used thing? 102. I thought I was at 1.3 before using it. It's the Horde Babylon. Okay. I lost some damage and speed. So I need to get back in the Deal with the Devil zone. Man, I'm picking the wrong path. So I basically, by going to that one boss trap room, have ruined all possibility of even considering boss rush. Good to know. By gaining health, I've decreased my ability to perform. It's not the end of the world. I don't need to do boss rush every time, but it's kind of starting to feel like going to the Old King. Like, it's not a necessity, but man, is it useful. I mean, we're gonna do it. and it was overall extremely not worth it. Now we're out of keys. Oh Lord. All right, don't throw this whole thing away. This run is too overall good for this many misplays. Overwatch. So the reason we were looking for, we downloaded a bunch of movies in Kansas City before we moved out here because we had Google Fiber. So we kind of got our grubby little mitts on as much as we could before we moved into a fiber-free zone, such as Seattle. You know, the techiest city of the Northwest has freaking garbage internet because of Comcast. But the main issue with that is we're unsure. We downloaded so much stuff that I don't really know what we have. We were looking to see if we had a copy of the horrible Mrs. Doubtfire-esque movie Soccer Mom that Jackie for some reason remembered, and I think it comes up pretty much every time we talk about the movie Ladybugs with Rodney Dangerfield. Essentially, Soccer Mom is, instead of a whereas Ladybugs is a boy dresses up like a girl to join the girls' soccer team, where he, of course, as the movie posits, just whips ass because, you know, the worst male soccer player is better than the best female soccer player. Just that's the premise. Like, this kid who's not good enough to do whatever on the male team is just able to go in there and, without really breaking a sweat, dominate. It's a pretty offensive premise. But you know, it's a Rodney Dangerfield comedy. It's not a fucking... It's not going for equality. It's well aware of its the fucked up nature of its starting conceit. And from that point, it just gets worse. Soccer Mom, however, takes the Mrs. Doubtfire approach a little bit more directly. And it's a mom of a kid that plays soccer who has her hopes fully set on meeting this Italian soccer superstar. And he's supposed to actually come and take over coaching this little league girls' soccer team, but he decides, like, no, that's not... I'm an actual world-famous soccer player. Why in the ever-loving hell would I do that? Which is a pretty reasonable thing for him to think. I mean, why would he teach any level of junior soccer? Anyway, so this woman goes to her friend, who is, of course, an expert at prosthetics, gets a false nose, gets her chin reshaped, and then she reads some books on Italian, and she becomes an exact duplicate of this guy. And the whole thing is, you know, some of the other moms have fallen in love with her. They want that sweet Italian dick. And she's got to be like, wow, there's no dick in there. And some of the other, the daughter, you know, the kid that's seen this woman since she was born, is slowly putting two and two together and thinking, you know, you seem a lot like my mom, what in the way that you behave exactly the way she does, and smell like her, and, you know, the exact height, and your accent's terrible, you sound like you're trying to be Eastern European half the time, etc., etc. You know, all the obvious reasons that someone who's really not good at performing does a bad job. See, in Mrs. Doubtfire, they covered that. This guy was a character actor, even in the world of the movie. He started off knowing how to perform these roles. So when he took over the role of Madame D herself, it kind of made sense. It kind of followed the path, like the natural path of things. Well, you got a character actor, of course you could act like a British nanny. It doesn't really excuse the whole cross-dressing as a joke premise, but, you know, at least it's a little less flimsy than mom reads 3 books on Italian and and convinces this entire small town that she is this guy who's on television probably more often than not. The most easily disprovable fabrication imaginable. She straight up picks a super famous dude and says, yeah, no, I'm him. Yeah, no, I know you can see him live on television right now, but look, that's me. I'm right here, but yes, I'm all, no, just shut up. That's me on the TV. I know that I'm right here right now, but shut up. So the moral of the story is we don't have a copy of that. And it's a little disappointing. Even the one trailer on YouTube of the movie looks like it was recorded on somebody's camcorder while they were watching it on their TV, and it's at like 420p or something. It's like the lowest quality video I've seen on YouTube, and it's kind of breaking apart and artifacting and all this kind of crazy shit. It just looks like it's such bad quality in every way. Not to mention, no offense to everybody that's on it. I think the
video?
Yeah.
That's good.
Oh yeah, you just finished it?
Oof, yes.
Super dark.
Yeah.
But you know, that needs to happen every once in a while in a movie. I was just talking about Soccer Mom, that movie I wasn't able to watch. That I would actually probably watch.
You what?
I would actually probably watch in a kind of so good it's bad. Wait! Wait!
Yeah.
So bad it's God. Kind of like. You're gonna get changed before you sit down? Oh, I guess you're not in your comfy clothes. Do you want to stream?
Maybe.
You should stream. I think people would really enjoy watching you. play Resident Evil. Yeah, Soccer Mom is a movie. Like, we all have movies that we've seen. Like, I've seen the Olsen Twin movies a lot. Not because I have some fascination. I'm actually, like... Okay, this is not me high-horsing. It's very weird that people are comfortable objectifying very young women. It's weird that they're comfortable objectifying women. Period. We all know that. It's fucked up. But like, the whole recently turned 18 and everyone's rip-roaring ready to go, bikini shots, etc., etc., is fucking gross to me. The Olsen twins were someone that I watched on TV or watched on movies a lot growing up because my sister loved It Takes Two. She loved the Olsen twin in like Mystery Squad, where they would solve these cheesy crime capers, or not crime capers, they were usually like, there wasn't like a nefarious villain or anything at the end. It was usually just like, here's something that's going on, let's figure it out. They're like an edutainment series for youngsters. And she loved them. She ate that shit up. That was her go-to. So I'd seen a ton of that. But, oh man, why was I even talking about this? But, like, oh yeah, Jackie's movie was Soccer Mom. There was another one that I watched. I think it was a Macaulay Culkin, Ted Danson movie. whoops, called Getting Even with Dad, or something along those lines, that I remember having watched a lot. That, Dunson Checks In and Blank Check were three movies that I don't know why I've seen so many times. Oh, I mean, I actually do know why. It's because my mom worked as a secretary at the Naval Weapons Station in Charleston, and there was a TV with a VCR on wheels that she could cart out of the thing, and we'd just go to Blockbuster before she had a long shift, and she was a single parent mom. She didn't have the luxury of daycare all the time. So we sat there, played Game Boy, worked on homework, and watched most of the time the exact same movies over and over and over again. If I get another key, I'm actually going to use that store credit. Or I'm going to remember it's there. Yeah. And then I'm going to remember to use it later. Did death not kill even one of these assholes? Yeah, those enemies are the... Ooh! Still gonna use it. Come back and pick up Booger there. Over there, pal. Just want to not spend money, because money equals power. If you haven't heard. Oh, wait, I didn't even need that. I should have just bought the key. That would have been a complete... Yeah, that would have been super circular to do essentially nothing. I don't like leaving opportunity on the floor, even if it means wasting my time a little bit. We don't need it. Yeah. Keep the Joker. We have a good enough chance of actually going to the deal with the devil on this floor. We are not even remotely near going to the, going to boss rush. It's 25 minutes. We were done with the entire last run in 34 minutes. We did have two freaking Emperor cards for the wound floors. This is still insanely good. Cliffy Athen. Alright, there's flight. Curse of the Blind, we're not going to use the freaking thing on a Curse of the Blind 4. We get a Degas, we'll consider it. But we're not using the Joker now. I'd honestly rather wait until there was no... Like a floor where there's no chance you can get a deal with the devil. Hey. Dark Bum. I think he's that slow on purpose. Man, it's weird having, like, actually zero keys. We could still, if we cared to, make it to Hush. But by doing this, I'm pretty much eradicating that possibility. Man, Papa Piece is starting to stream a sub 15 minute dungeon run. Or that's what he's aiming for. That's crazy to me. Just zip right past that one. Don't stop and think about it. It's fucking insane how how much different you are at this game by the end.
I have good news.
What is it?
There's another one somewhere
over here. That's not good news. It's terrible news.
Some lessons I've
learned. I might have to set up your stream, so let me. If you're gonna do it, let me finish this run, which will not take much longer. But you can make sure the game is working at least. And can you open OBS? Yeah. I can't believe I just walked into that guy's bullet. Or tear, or whatever the fuck. You might have to turn on that upper screen. Ow, my back! God, it'd be really cool if, like, there was one part of my body that just didn't hurt at all. That'd be so cool. Alright, new enemies are still fucking my shit all up. It might not be plugged in. I'll figure it out in a second. And if it is, yeah, you might have to go to where it says camera and, on OBS and do something. Okay, we're not going to hatch. We're just gonna, I guess, just crush through the rest of this run. Mama Gertie is, like, the easiest freaking fight in the world if you have flight. She's pretty much the easiest fight in the world. In any circumstance. Alright, so we're using some HP. No, we're not. Fuck.
Health up.
Shit. Oh, OBS is just not even working right now. I think your computer, when it slept for a while, has,
Restart.
No, you don't have to restart. It just takes a while for the programs to get going. Because it kind of sits in like a limbo mode for a lot of the time. So we're a little weaker on this floor because of, well, that's stupid. Because of some of the unlucky situations at the last floor. But it's not that bad. Not sure which is better. You know what? We have Dark Bomb. Let's be bold. And do what's gonna be a little faster. Go ahead, DB. There's so many keys just dropping. So we get 6 damage whenever we're in the cloud of succubus. Alright, we need to take 2 hearts worth of. Ah, shit. Well, we can do the last heart on the next floor. As long as it's not C of the B. Camera's working.
Yeah, I have to get that out.
It's really silly looking though. Okay, so I don't think we have Curse of the Blind. Why is what not in front? Oh, that's what it is. You need to lift that up higher.
How do I get out of the game?
Alt tab. It might take a second. Ugh. Yeah, so. Put game, grab where it says camera. There you go. Now, if you right click it,
hit properties and then configure video. You can adjust where it is, go to the next one, camera controls, and then you can kind of zoom it and move it left or right
with pan and tilt. Pan is left or right, tilt is up and down. Yes! Oh my god, what a perfect freaking thing. He's got higher damage shots than I do. That's like the best thing we could have. Besides just getting Guppy there, that's the best we could have hoped for.
And then I go to Twitch.
Yeah, you gotta go to Twitch / Wing Wong Witch / dashboard.
/ live?
No. Huh?
/ live?
No, that's gonna be your channel. So there should be one that says Wing Wong Witch / dashboard. Oh, wait, I think the live screen might be the actual one. Yeah. Yeah, sorry, I forgot they changed that around a little bit. Alright, I can't even tell where I am. This is great. More damage, please. 0.54. Okay. Dude, these guys are the worst addition. The only thing, and this is not a complaint, I wish I had Incubus a little bit closer so I could control him better, but I'd rather have him and not have perfect control than not have him. So you see on OBS where it says...
Start streaming,
yeah.
Button to wear the headset.
Oh yeah, because that's your microphone. We can get you a mic, but... For now, that's your mic.
Yeah.
So you grab the headset and put it on your head, and then you put the
sounds come out though.
See this little thing right here?
Mm-hmm.
You just click it, and then go to monitor. So they should all hear. Yeah. That's how you went for camera?
Yep.
Yeah, you actually got a lot of that pretty quickly without me coming. Like, it's a wall on the top screen. Very nice. So this will be your
okay.
It looks good.
Stream it up.
You do it. Then you just click back into the thing when you're into the game when you're ready to
go. All right, nice. We got Jackie's stream set up. She actually is completely on top of it. That's fucking dope.
Hello.
The first like 30 seconds are probably going to be cut off. Just a heads up. You can do your welcome a bunch of times just in case. Just give it a second. I think that's one of the Capcom does this weird thing where loading into and out of their games pauses for a lot longer than it would seem like you need to pause.
It's a stream offline.
Hmm?
It's a stream offline on chat.
Yeah, it'll start off saying that. It takes a while for your stream to... Oh. That's why I was saying that the beginning's going to be cut off. Try hitting Alt-Tab again.
I think I hear the music, or it's just...
That might be my Isaac music. It's just scary in our house. Yeah, okay. I'm almost done with this. I never even realized how Head of the Keeper and Money Equals Power is such a good thing. Yeah, you might have to restart your computer. It's been a long time since it's been restarted, so it's probably a good idea. Anyway, oof, I just got crazy bombs. And crazy damage, holy crap. I'm excited, goddammit. Wow, that was the worst thing that could have happened right there. Well, the least useful thing that would have really happened. You might have to just hold the power button. It seems like it's, like, full-on frozen. So give it like 2 minutes, 30 seconds or so, between 30 seconds and 2 minutes, and then just turn it back on. It's gonna take a little while for it to start up because I don't have an SSD in that one. No, it doesn't stand for suck suck dick, Jackie. It still doesn't. You've guessed that like 4 times. You can't act like I'm coming out of nowhere with it. Jesus Christ. Well, now that I have so much going on, it's actually, like, harder to tell what's happening with me in this freaking game. Which is always one of the concerns. It's not at the point where I need to worry, though. Okay. Darkbone, it's all up to you. To keep this ship afloat. Man, we gotta... I kinda wanted to race to the end.
Did you see what I had on the screen?
I did not.
President Beavis 2.
Why? I don't understand it. I don't. The president in the game is named Beavis?
Yeah.
Why? That's a terrible name for a president.
You understand.